Welcome to iLecture Online. Trying to represent a triad is a little bit more difficult. A triad is a tensor of rank 3, and even though we may not commonly encounter those kind of things in everyday life, even when we take advanced physics or mathematics, we still need to know how to deal with it just in case we encounter it. So how do you physically represent it? And obviously, trying to represent it via a matrix is a little bit more difficult because now it becomes a three-dimensional structure with 27 components. So what we do realize is we're going to have 27 components, and each of the components is going to have three subscripts, an I, a J, and a K. Well, I, J, K is kind of representative of three different directions or three different dimensions, even though I doesn't just represent the X direction, J just Y, and K just the Z direction, but at least it gives you kind of an idea that there's going to be three ways in which you have to count the directions I, J, K. So the first count is the first subscript, and we call that the representation of the row. So this represents row X, row Y, row Z, and it increases as we go down. We could also say row 1, row 2, row 3, and so that might be a better way to write it. So that would be sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 in the first subscript. The second subscript represents the columns, and so we have column 1, column 2, column 3, or column X, column Y, column Z. And then the third dimension, you work from the front backwards, we call that the page. The first page, the second page, the third page, so there'll be three slices of 9 components like that, one after the other. So what I've tried to do here is kind of represent what it would look like if we could look inside a cube of a triad like that, representing the different components, but we can only see the first set of components. We can't see beyond the first set. So looking from this direction right here, we'd see the first 9 of 3 slices of 9, or 3 pages of 9 components. So this would be the first of the 3 pages of 9 components, and so this is the way it would be laid out. The first subscript here representing the rows would go from 1, 2, 3, or X, Y, Z. Then going from left to right, we represent the three columns, so we go from the second subscript would be X for the first column, Y for the second column, Z for the third column, or it would be 1, 2, 3 if you like to work with 1, 2, 3s. And then when we go from the front to the back, the three pages, the first page represents, that would be represented by the third subscript. So in this case, all of the ones, all the third subscripts of this first page have the exact same indicator, X or 1. So we would have 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 1. We have 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1. And here we'd have 3, 1, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 3, 1. If you want to represent it by ones and twos and threes instead of X, Ys, and Zs. Then if we look from the side here, notice that the first three are the same as these three right here, because now we're looking at it from the side. So these three would be re-represented here. But notice now we're going backwards. So this would be the first page, the second page, and the third page. And we're looking at all the components on the right side of the three pages. So you can see that going from top to bottom, we have X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z, X, Y, Z. Going from left to right, since we're only looking at the right column here, all the second components will be Z's for every one of these 9 components. I should say all the second subscripts would be a Z for all 9 components. And then for the third subscript, the front page would have a component X, the second page would have component Y, and the third page would have component Z. Notice that we have the top left corner is XXX, the bottom right corner is ZZZ. Now we're looking at it again from the very top right here. So again, we're only seeing the first three of the 9 components of each page, but from the top. So that would be page 1, page 2, page 3. Since it's page 1, 2, 3, we see X, Y, and Z for the third subscript of the 3 pages. Notice that we're at the very top, so that means that's all represent the first row. So the first subscript of all 9 components would be X. And then going from left to right to represent the columns, notice the second subscript is X for the first column, Y for the second column, Z for the third column. So hopefully that gives you a little bit more of insight of how the components are laid out for a triad. Now that alone doesn't give you the total picture, so we're going to try to represent it in various different ways to get a better feel for it, what a triad structure looks like and how the subscripts are laid out. But again, the best way to remember is top, bottom, row, first subscript, left to right, column, second subscript, front to back, page, third subscript, and that's probably the best way to look at it. And that's how it's done.